Okay, so this is gonna be like a non-traditional video. As you can see, I have on no makeup, all that stuff. You guys are gonna be like, WTF, CC, what the F are you doing? I know. This one was really not my, I guess it was my fault because I used the product, but it really wasn't. I don't know. My hair was doing so well. So if you guys have not seen the title, I wore a lace front wig and I bonded it with something stronger than the Got To Be Glued, which I should have just stuck with that, but I bonded it with something stronger, which I'll show you in a minute, and it just gone. Balls snatched, gone. So seriously, I've only worn a lace front wig like once or twice, and I've always used the Got To Be Glued, never anything stronger, but I was going on a trip. If you guys wanna see snippets of the trip and everything like that, check out my vlog channel as well as my social media, and there's stuff all up there. But anyway, I wanted something a little stronger than the Got To Be Glued. Sometimes I have problems with like the flap lipping up or something like that by the ear for the lace front wig. So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna try this product I bought a while ago. I haven't really tried it. Well, never tried it, and I'm gonna try it now. So yeah, I used the product like normal, everything was fine, and then when it came to remove it, I used their recommended remover because I also purchased the remover. I used that also, and I put a whole lot of it on. I probably used half the damn bottle, and it still removed my edges with it. So that being said, I'm going to show you guys the product right now. I used the Cling. This is from Ossiworks, but I heard people talking about it. So I'd heard people talking about this. I knew there was a possibility that we could get in a pool because we were staying at a hotel, and I wanted to wear this lace front wig, but I didn't want, obviously, my hair to come off. The Got To Be Glued would not hold up in a pool. So I went with this. This is supposed to be water resistant, adhesive, moisture control, oily scalp, high humidity, no harsh chemicals. So this was supposed to be really good and hold up in water. The only way this was supposed to come off was with the remover. So the remover is their recommended. This is the Uncling Coconut Oil Adhesive Remover for safe and easy removal of cling lace glue. So I made sure to purchase both of these, and I definitely use this to take off the lace wig, but it still messed up my edges. So for those of you who are longtime subscribers, probably like a year ago, almost exactly a year ago, I posted a video called I Hate My Natural Hair. And I also posted a video showing you guys how I straightened and colored my natural hair using a keratin treatment. And I really just ruined my hair, so I went ahead and big chopped after that. So from that video, you guys got to see how thin my edges were. But over the last year, my hair and my edges and everything have really grown back and really started to look actually pretty good. So this is just really disappointing because I feel like it's another setback for me. And I mean, it's just hair, it's gonna grow back. So I'm not like overly like panicky, but it is very irritating because I've worked very hard to get my edges to a good point. So let me just show you guys what I'm talking about. It's not as bad on this side. So I just have on like a half wig, and I pulled it back a little bit so you guys can see my edges. It's really not as bad on this side. This side actually came off okay. I mean, you can see it's a little thin right here. But from that, I don't know if that's what my hair was already or if that's from the cling. I can't really blame that on the cling because I'm not sure, even though it wouldn't surprise me. I don't feel like my edges were this thin right here, but I just don't know. So my other side is a little more severe. I don't know what happened over here. So this is what we're dealing with over here. So as you can see, it also like hit me up here, like in the front a little bit. And if you can see, there's like a red mark right here because I don't know if it was just too harsh for my scalp or what, but there's like a red mark right there. Like it somehow burned my scalp or something. But then if you move to the other side, this is where it gets a lot more severe. Literally, I had hair here and this whole part is like bald, like gone. I mean, it's awful. And then there's a red mark here as well. Another little, I'm gonna zoom you guys in so you guys can see it. All right, so that's a little closer. So there's like another little scalp burn right there from what that stuff did to my hair. So I don't really know what I did wrong. I feel like I say that in all of my hair videos. I'm like, I don't know what I did wrong, but I really don't. But yeah, at this point, that's what we're working with. That's how my edges look. It didn't affect the rest of my hair. Like, the rest of my hair is still growing and thriving, but that is just very disappointing because I worked very hard to try to grow my hair back. So I'm kind of irritated about that. So before this whole disaster, I was actually using a product that I really loved for my edges. I felt like they were really in a good, healthy place. And this is the Natural Club Jamaican Black Castor Oil Growth Serum. So I showed you all this growth serum in my hair wash routine video. So if you guys haven't seen that, make sure you check it out up here. But I showed you guys this growth serum, and I've been using this for about 4 weeks now, and I felt like it was really strengthening my edges and really helping them grow back. And so I've been using this on my hair as well as my daughter's hair, just massaging it into our edges probably like every 2-3 days, and I felt like it was really making a difference. So what I'm gonna do is, actually now I feel like this is the perfect time to put this to more of a test. And I know it was working somewhat, but I just can't be sure of how much, just because I mean my edges were already growing back. So this was aiding in that, but I just can't be sure of how much. So what I'm gonna do is use this exclusively on my edges, and we're gonna try this out for the next couple of months. They sent me this as well as the same thing in the Wild Lavender scent. I like that one better because it smells better, but they both work the same. So I'm gonna be using these on my edges for the next 1 to 2 months to see just if it really, really helps and does the trick and helps grow my edges back, because now I feel like we have a blank, for lack of a better word, a blank canvas to work with. So I'm excited to try these. I've also been using castor oil, but I'm actually gonna set this aside and only use this. I think this is like mostly castor oil anyway, so I'm only gonna use this just because I think it'll be easier to determine if it's actually working. So I'm gonna give you guys updates on this stuff and let you know what I think. So far, as I was using it before, I really felt like it was doing something for my hair as well as my daughter's hair, but now again, I feel like we'll have a better picture of how it works since my edges are damn near gone now. So yeah. Moral of the story of this video is, don't use any of those really harsh bonds for your lace wigs. If you're gonna use something, just stick to the gel. I think there's a ghost bond out there. There's like, I just use this cling, and there's other stuff out there. I mean, I don't know, maybe I did it wrong, but I feel like the safest way is just to stay away from that stuff and only use the gel if you're going to do a lace wig. Like, I was expecting a little bit of hair to come out, but not as much as what did. So I am just a little traumatized right now, but it is what it is. It'll grow back. And again, now I can really test out these products for you guys and let you know what I think. So a lot of people have negative things to say and wondering why I make these videos, why I make all of these hair fail videos and all of that stuff. And really, honestly, it's just to show my journey. I like to document what I'm doing. That's why I'm on YouTube. I like to document what I'm doing and share my experiences, because I know I'm not the only one going through natural hair woes, okay? Hair itself is just such a big part of, I feel like, our lives. Like, hair is huge. Whether you have hair or whether you don't have hair, it's kind of a defining thing for you. So my hair is something that I'm really, really trying to take care of, really trying to grow back after everything that happened last year. And I want to document my journey, whether whatever I'm doing works or whether it doesn't work. I can't be the only one out here making these mistakes. So if I can show you guys what doesn't work and then, you know, give a tip on what I think will work or whatever the case, if I'm helping one person, then I am a happy person and I'm doing my job, and that's what I love to do, and it's the reason that I'm here on YouTube. So if you don't like videos like this, just click out of it. Like, people have a lot of negative things to say when I post these videos, and sometimes it just irritates me. Like, you don't have to watch. Did you not know that? I'm pretty sure you did. You don't have to watch. But I just wanted to give that little spiel because I'm all about positivity and I'm all about helping people out, even if it's showing them what I did incorrectly. So you guys, that is really it for this video. Thank you guys for watching. I hope it was helpful and informative and it stops you from using this stuff, or at least using it in a better way than I used it, okay? I love you guys so, so much. Don't forget to follow me on all of my social media, my Instagram, my Snapchat, and also my Facebook fan page. It's the best way to keep up with me in between uploads, along with my family vlog channel. Head on over there and subscribe so you can see the little details from our little vacation slash workcation that we went on last week. I love you guys so, so much. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel, and I will talk to you in the next video. Bye guys.